How's it going, everybody? Ben Larry here. I want to show you what I've been working on. I've been working on a system to keep track of networking events so that I don't miss things and so that I don't forget to check for the next dates and stuff. Because what I was finding is there's all kinds of interesting events to attend. You know, they're on Meetup, they're on Facebook, but I felt like it was very fragmented and hard to keep on top of everything. Like, even I might go to a meeting, like Yes Group or something, but then I might forget about next month's event, you know, and then I'll bump into somebody and they'll say, oh, did you go to this month's meeting? I'm like, no, I forgot about it. I didn't have a system for like staying on top of it, you know? So I wanted to create a system for staying on top of it. This system's gonna keep track of things I've attended and it's gonna prompt me to check for the latest dates. And it's gonna put the Facebook page in front of me or the Meetup page in front of me so I can have a look, check for the latest dates, put the new dates in the list, and I'm constantly staying on top of it, okay? That's what I wanted to do. And I would suggest that this would be a useful tool for a lot of people, okay? So here's the essence of it. It's based on a Google Sheet, obviously. Now, the idea is when you find a new club or a new meeting, that goes on the organization's list. And I created a form in order to do that. So say you bump into somebody and they say, oh, Ben, you would really enjoy Handstand Property Group, North Wales. They would love you. You should really go there. You'd have a lot of fun. Okay, so I take their advice. I put Handstand Property Group because that sounds like a real thing, doesn't it? We'll call it Club. Handstand Property Club, North Wales. Okay, so I submit that. Now, if we go to the form, it's going to automatically put that on list this. Where's it gone? Handstand Property Club, North Wales. There it is. And it automatically reorders it alphabetically, right? So we've created the club. Now, I've got a separate form. Let me just refresh it. Handstand Property Club is going to appear on the drop-down list. There it is, okay? So I can put in the event date. So I'm going to call it the January meetup. Whoops. The January meetup. What should we say? It's the 5th Jan 2020 and the start time is 7 p.m. And of course, there's other details, you can put links and stuff like that. So I submit that and that goes over here onto the event sheet. There it is. There it is. It appears right there. Why is that clickable? That's weird. Anyway, so we've put it on my event sheet. Now, that's cool. So now we can just input events. Every time you see something, every time you hear about something, just input, input, input. Now you might think, why don't I just use the diary? Why don't I just use Google Calendar? I prefer to do it like this because it's the data's in raw form on a sheet. I can manipulate the data. I can do stuff with it. I can get Google App script to email me. I can do more stuff when I've got the raw data. Yeah, the calendar app is nice, but it doesn't give me all these functions that I want to be able to customize, if that makes sense. So now here's one here's something that was really important to me. When I've attended events, so let's say I go along to Handstand Property Club North Wales, I'm going to put a tick box there, right? Now, because I've attended, what's going on here? There we go. The formula didn't copy down. Because I've attended it, it's going to prompt me if I want to rebook. And what happens is, let me just get this right. If I go onto the filter page, the spreadsheet is going to give me a list of the events that I have attended because it's filtering the ticks. And what it's going to do is email me and prompt me to rebook these, right? So every day it's going to take this list and say, do you want to rebook them? Now, I haven't actually done it yet, but I'm also going to insert like the homepage, the Facebook page, the Meetup page. So it's going to prompt me with the name, give me the links, and it makes me very easy for me to just quickly have a look on their page, see when the next event is, you know. Let's just say it emails me and it says, do you want to rebook Handstand Property Club? I'll have a look. I see there's a February event on the 6th of Feb. And so what I do is I go back to my event form and then input the new event, and it allows me to constantly stay on top of it all without missing anything, without forgetting about things, does that make sense? It's a system. So that's essentially it. Now, in its current state, it's quite I mean, it's a little bit messy, it's a little bit raw. I can tidy it up and improve the code. And I got some really good programming advice from a video I was watching and from an experienced software developer. And he says, the way you do it is you get it working and then you go back through it and tidy it up, improve it and stuff. What you don't do is try and get it all perfect straight away, because that task just never ends. You can't get it working if you're trying to get every last detail immaculate. It takes too long, right? Get it working first, then go back through, clean it up. Go back through, clean it up some more. Go back through, add some functions. That's the way you do it. That's the way I'm doing it. I've got it working. As an example, I'll show you how it's not tidy yet. I'll show you. Here's the first email it sent me, and look at that. What a mess. It's horrible. It's put all the names of all the groups in one line instead of, you know, in nice bullet points. And it's got these horrible lines here. But that's okay, because it works, and that's fine for version 1. And now I'll tidy it up. Okay. Thank you, everyone.